So last year in quarantine, I built myself a pull-up bar, aka I got my dad to build me a pull-up bar, and it turned out I could not do a single pull-up. After a lot of practicing on that pull-up bar and then again at the gym once they reopened, I can now do 6 pull-ups per set. So this is me in May of 2021, and I'm basically going to show you exactly how I did it. So today is kind of going to be a more tester day because I want to see like where I'm at with pull-ups. I have only been able to do like 3 chin-ups in a row in the past and maybe 1 pull-up. I'll put in a video that I have from literally my college gym. Holy crap. Also, as you guys know, I stopped dieting, so I gained like 15 pounds, and pull-ups are super, super, super body weight dependent. I don't want to use like, I'm too heavy to do pull-ups as an excuse. That's like BS. I don't believe in it. So I'm just gonna train as hard as I can. Okay, so I have 3 different band sizes to do assisted pull-ups with. So there's the green, which is the thickest, purple is medium, black is the thinnest. And basically you loop these around and put your feet through. I'll show you guys, or you can put your knees through. And basically they just like, since they're really thick and elastic, I don't know, they help pull you up. Okay, so basically nothing. Listen, this is what I figured. The worse you are in the beginning, the more room there is for improvement. And like, the more you can look back and be like, ha ha ha, look how bad I was. Okay, last one we're gonna do is the black band. Not gonna lie, I'm kinda disappointed with that purple. If I can get 1 with this, I'll be happy, but I'm gonna guess 0 with this one. Pretty bad, to be honest. I remember like when I was really practicing these, like obviously I was practicing sets with the black near the end, right? This is the thing that's really discouraging about training is that if you stop, it kinda like disappears. But the thing is, if you start again, it all like reappears pretty fast. So my first approach to pull-ups was pretty crude, and it was basically frequency. Welcome to day 2. Day 3, it's day 7. I decided I would do pull-ups every single day for 30 days using the resistance band and just see what happened. I'm gonna need to do something about my hands because they were dying. Obviously I don't have calluses right now because we haven't been to the gym for like actual months. I can't find my gym gloves. I totally forgot the limiting factor in pull-ups is your f***ing grip. Holy shit, my hands hurt so much. I totally forgot that. I was kept thinking back. No, the first thing that's gonna go is your grip, for sure. Holy crap a moly. My lats are so freaking sore. I took a rest day yesterday because my calluses are really, they're taking me down, okay? They're taking me the fuck down. But I did find my real gym gloves. Okay, I'm really glad I did take that day off because these felt so much easier today. Like 2 days ago, they were such a slog. It's been raining all day today, but it's 7 p.m. and I'm coming here to get it in because no excuses. I've been exposed. I already missed a day this week. That was my bad. It was raining all day yesterday and I just didn't feel like freaking getting wet in the rain. But I promise I will not miss any more days this week. I almost didn't come out today because it's almost 8 p.m. and I didn't do my pull-ups yet, and I was just gonna say, oh, it's okay, it's one other day, blah, 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 it doesn't matter. But sir, not today. It's 8 p.m. again and I'm back to the purple band today. What's up? Okay, you guys, I've been waiting all day for this rain to stop and it has not, so I think I'm just gonna have to get somebody to film me from up here on the balcony so the camera can stay sheltered. Although it looks like it stopped for a little bit, but that's the thing. It keeps stopping and starting and stopping and starting. I'm afraid to like put my camera out there and just like let my camera die if it starts raining.
Oh yeah, kind of.
All right, so Irma's gonna record from the balcony.
Well, they were never cheap, ever. But they really.
I did one pull-up and I felt a twinge in my left shoulder. If I ever feel a twinge, I stop, because a twinge is never just a twinge. Guess we'll call it a day for today. I'm not gonna say I'm too upset about it because it's 90 degrees out here. I'm done. Okay, so it's 90 degrees and I'm literally like dying of heat stroke, but there was no shoulder pain today. Everything felt fine. Everything felt good, so we dodged a bullet. I may or may not have also taken 2 days off this week, guys. I'm really, 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 really sorry. I didn't mean to, and this time it actually just was my fault, and it was not because I was sore or anything, and it was just because I was busy editing a video, which is no excuse. Anyways, let's just not talk about it. So it rained out here like just an hour ago and it's like 8 p.m. and I legitimately feel the mosquitoes eating me alive. Being eaten alive. A mosquito just bit me on the f***ing face. So after 30 days of doing pull-ups every day, I had made some improvements. I started off not being able to do any with the purple band. All right, I think we'll try to go for 4. Let's see what happens. Wish me luck. Fingers crossed, can't cross them because my gloves. To doing 4 with the purple band. Woo! And I also went from not doing any with the black to being able to do 1, but I lost the video clip. But I still couldn't do any real pull-ups. Luckily for us, that is when gyms decided to reopen. Okay, so the next thing we're going to be talking about is how you train your pull-ups in the gym. So once gyms reopened in the summer, I obviously had access to a lot more equipment, so I got a lot more strategic about the way I was approaching my pull-ups, which helped a lot. The first thing you want to do before you do your pull-ups is warm up your back. I know this part is really boring and you'll be tempted to skip it, but that is how you get injured, so do not skip your warm-up. You can do this a ton of different ways. I like to use a PVC pipe or bands or just a mat. It really doesn't matter, guys. We're just trying to get blood flow into the upper body. The next thing we're going to talk about is arguably the most important thing in getting a pull-up, and that is scapular retraction. Your scapula is basically your shoulder blades, and you want to make sure that they are pulled back at the bottom of your pull-up. Retracting your scapula is the way that every single pull-up is going to start, so it is absolutely crucial to master scapular retraction. Okay, so we can practice this a few different ways. The first thing that I'm going to show you here is scap push-ups. So basically, you are holding the top of a push-up position, and then you are basically just practicing pulling your shoulder blades back and rolling them forward, and do this over and over again. We are just practicing that motion. Another thing you can do is go to a lat pull down machine, and instead of performing the full lat pull down, you are just pulling your shoulder blades down and back. So your arms are staying straight the entire time and you're just practicing that really, really small range of motion. Finally, the last way you can try it is by hanging on a pull-up bar and again doing the same motion, pulling your shoulder blades down and back. One thing that might be helpful to imagine is that you are trying to put your shoulder blades in your back pocket. So the reason this is so important is because when your shoulder blades are retracted, it allows you to engage your back in the pull-up. If your shoulders are rolled forward, the entire pull-up is going to be in your arms, and I don't know if you've noticed this, but your arm muscles are quite a bit smaller than your back muscles, aka they're quite a bit weaker. So doing a pull-up without your scapula retracted is almost impossible. At first, when you do this motion, your shoulder blades are probably not going to move that much because we're not really used to moving this muscle, and we probably have a really bad mind-to-muscle connection with it, but just keep practicing it. The more you practice it, the better you will get at it. The next thing we're going to be talking about is the assisted pull-up machine. I know a lot of people like to do pull-ups on this when they are trying to get their pull-up. I personally don't love the assisted pull-up machine, and after listening to a lot of trainers talk about it, I was pretty much convinced that it's not the best machine to practice your pull-ups with, and that's basically because it provides you a lot of stability that you don't have when you're hanging from a free bar. So it just makes the movement a lot easier than it should be. And also, I find that when people are on the assisted pull-up machine, they're doing sets of 8, which is probably not the most useful rep range to be working in, because we are trying trying to get our first pull-up, which is a one rep max kind of. So working in sets of eight just really doesn't make sense. So instead, as you guys have seen in the video so far, I like to use bands a lot. Bands approximate a real pull-up a lot better because you're still having to stabilize your core on the way up and down. And the thicker the band, the more assistance it's gonna provide you. The thinner the band, the less assistance, obviously. Start off with a band where you can do about 4 to 6 reps, I would say. And once you can do 4 sets cleanly of 4 to 6 reps, I would move on to a lighter band. And then the last thing we're gonna be talking about is something that I really focused on once I had kind of finished with the bands, and that is slow negatives. So the negative of a movement is the lowering. So when you're pulling up, that is the positive. When you're lowering yourself down, that is the negative. We are always stronger in the negative portion of a movement than we are in the positive. It's a protective mechanism that your body has so that you don't get hurt when you are putting weights down or putting things back or whatever. So because we are stronger in the negative of a range of motion, we can really use it to our advantage to get stronger in the positive as well. So slow negatives in your pull-ups are basically you're going to take out the positive portion of the pull-up entirely by jumping up to the top of the bar, and then you are going to slowly lower yourself down as slowly as you can. The slower you go, the harder it is. When you first start out, you might find that you're not even really slowly lowering yourself down. You're just kind of falling down in a controlled way. But the stronger you get, the more slowly you'll be able to lower yourself down. And one thing you should also notice with slow negatives is that you'll find there are different parts in the range of motion where you might be weaker. So maybe in the middle of that range of motion, you all of a sudden slip down really fast. It's a really good mental note to keep that, like, okay, I'm weakest in this part of the pull-up, so that's the part I'm gonna squeeze hardest at and work the hardest at getting better, because the more we can eliminate those weak points in the pull-up, the closer you will get to getting your real pull-up. And the last thing I want to mention is that you do need to keep a pretty strong core during pull-ups, because if you don't, you're just gonna kind of be swinging around, and not contracting your core is gonna allow for a lot of energy leaks in the movement. So what that basically means is if you are focused on really keeping your entire body tight as you pull up, you are going to be stronger in your pull-up. So I would try to keep your legs straight, maybe even keep your toes pointed, and work on some core exercises like hollow holds or decline sit-ups. Overall, 100%, the most important part of pull-ups is being patient, because they are a difficult movement, but once you get it, it's not gonna be that hard to keep it. It just takes frequency, practice, time. You can do it. And once you can do it, it's so exciting, guys, because guess what? If you're ever hanging from a cliff, you're not gonna die anymore, which I think is a great benefit. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching the video. This video has been over a year in the making. I'm so glad I finally did it, because I had over a year of footage to go through. I'm so happy. In terms of the timeline, between when I made the 30 days of pull-ups video and when I made the first bodyweight pull-up, that was about 3 months. And then it took me about 3 more months after that to get about 5 pull-ups in a set. So that's just how long it took me. Obviously, it's very individual. The first time I ever learned a chin-up in 2018, it took me 6 months to be able to do one. So obviously, a lot of strength had been grown since that time period. And I'm just really happy, because legitimately at the beginning, I thought like I wouldn't be able to do one because I was too heavy. I don't really know too many people my weight that can do pull-ups, and I don't know, I'm just really happy that I didn't let that stop me and I kept trying, and now I can do 6. If you liked this video, please like it. It really helps out the video. Comment below, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!